Good evening, everybody. I'm David Owen Norris, and at the end of a rainbow-strewn autumn day here in London, welcome to Wigmore Hall, where tonight's concert is given by the Doric String Quartet. Alex Reddington and Ying Shui, violins, Hélène Clément, viola, and the cellist John Myerscough. The quartet was formed in 1998 and undertook specialist study in Paris and Basel. In 2015, they were appointed as teaching quartet in association at the Royal Academy of Music at the other end of Wimpole Street from Wigmore Hall. 2 years ago, the quartet took over the artistic directorship of the Mendelssohn on Mole Festival, playing a key role in the festival's core mission of providing young professionals with a week of intensive mentoring, coaching, and development. They'll begin their programme with Mozart's second so-called Prussian quartet, one of a set of three written with the King of Prussia in mind. Friedrich Wilhelm II, whom Mozart met in 1789, was a keen amateur cellist, as we might suspect when we hear the piece in a moment. Next, Mendelssohn's great quartet in E minor, Opus 44, number 2, which reached its final form in 1839. The outer two movements are brilliant synthesis of drama and melody, those in between exploring two characteristic Mendelssohn specialities, the fairy-like dancing scherzo and the song without words. The Doric's programme will end with one of the touchstone works of the string quartet genre, the first of Haydn's Opus 33 quartets of 1781. Haydn had become world famous enough to renegotiate his contract with Prince Esterhazy. Hitherto, it had been the prince who owned all Haydn's compositions, but now Opus 33 was the first work Haydn published under the new dispensation, and Haydn made sure it made a splash. Mozart had recently arrived in Vienna, and he was so impressed with Haydn's new way of writing quartets that he wrote some of his own after a gap of 9 years since he'd last written quartets, nearly a quarter of his life, so a significant hole. Haydn dedicated his Opus 33 to Grand Duke Paul of Russia, so they're sometimes called his Russian quartets. Now, the well-spaced audience here in Wigmore Hall is about to welcome the Doric String Quartet to the stage for their performance of Mozart's String Quartet in B-flat, Kirche number 589, composed in 1790. It's got the usual four movements: fast, slow, minuet, and very fast.
Thank you.
The Doric String Quartet have just played Mozart's second Prussian quartet here in Wigmore Hall, long the home of great chamber music. Next, we'll advance half a century and travel from Vienna to Leipzig for Mendelssohn's E minor quartet, opus 44, number 2. This piece is dedicated to the Crown Prince of Sweden, something of a composer himself, and, by the way, the son of one of Napoleon's marshals, Bernadotte. Funny turns life takes sometimes. I was thinking about the ways that Napoleon has affected the world of music, and of course everybody knows about Beethoven's Egmont Overture and the Eroica Symphony and his battle symphony, Wellington's Victory. And I like to think of the Siege of Vienna in 1809, which wasn't really, I suppose, the sort of thing one should like to think of, but the picture of the elderly Haydn playing his emperor's hymn as an act of defiance to the besieging French troops, Beethoven trying to preserve his hearing, cowering in a cellar with a pillow over his ear, and Schubert, who at that time was a young choir boy in St. Stephen's Cathedral, and the choir boys used to have a habit during the siege of running round the still extant medieval walls of Vienna and throwing back unexploded hand grenades, which so worried the emperor that he had to pass a special law to prevent it. It's extraordinary to think of the way that great composers had connections with these terribly violent events, and composers of all stripes and all nationalities, of course, were moved to pay their tributes. Tchaikovsky's 1812 overture, our own Samuel Wesley's Battle of Salamanca, and so on. Anyway, Mendelssohn's masterpiece of a quartet has four movements, and here comes the Doric Quartet back on the Wigmore stage to perform it for us. quite a roller coaster as Mendelssohn cuts his beats in three and then cuts them in three yet again. Mendelssohn's E minor quartet, played in Wigmore Hall by the Doric String Quartet. Alex Reddington and Ying Shui, violins, Hélène Clément, viola, and the cellist John Myerscough. The Doric String Quartet will return to Wigmore Hall later this season. These concerts are free to enjoy for online audiences, but none of this would be possible without your support. If you're watching, please make a donation to help fund this series and support these wonderful musicians. A fascinating detail for those of us who've loved the musical scene here in Britain all our lives, the quartet's violist, Hélène Clément, plays the viola that Frank Bridge gave to his pupil, Benjamin Britten, on the quayside in Southampton in 1939, as Britten set off to America. They never saw each other again. That's the instrument that Britten recorded Purcell's Fantasy on One Note upon with the Amadeus String Quartet. And talking of string quartets, another famous occasion in Southampton took place when the remains of Béla Bartók were taken back from New York, where he had died, to his native Hungary. And the ship with the coffin in put in at Southampton docks on the way, and the enterprising folk at Southampton University put on a concert at the Turner Sims Concert Hall in Southampton, where they played Bartók string quartets in honour of the composer then passing through the city. The Doric String Quartet will conclude their concert with the first of Haydn's Opus 33 set. Famously, the musicologist Donald Francis Tovey said, "There's no more important documents than Haydn's string quartets." And certainly the Opus 33 set, as I said earlier on, was Haydn really making a splash with his new way of writing string quartets. I won't mention the key that this one's in because Haydn very wittily pretends it's in quite a different one, and it would be a pity to spoil his joke. So there are four movements: Allegro Moderato, a very fast Scherzo, an Andante, and a Presto Finale. The Doric Quartet will come back on stage now to play Haydn's Opus 33, number one.
Thank you.
Haydn, showing the world his new way of writing string quartets in 1781. Opus 33, number 1, in B minor, though Haydn began by pretending it's in D major. It concludes this concert of Mozart, Mendelssohn and Haydn by the Doric String Quartet. Alex Reddington and Ying Shui, violins, Hélène Clément, viola, and the cellist John Myerscough. Our thanks to the artists. They've just gone off stage. Here they come again. Will they give us an encore, I wonder? Very appreciative audience, even if the Wigmore Hall is only 20% full this evening. Well spaced. Yes, an encore.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. We'd like to play for you, as an encore, the slow movement of Mozart's D major Prussian quartet, Kirchhoff 575.
slow movement of Mozart's second Prussian quartet. And of course, the concert began with the first Prussian quartet. K575, the Andante from Körper number 575, bringing that concert to a peaceful, restful conclusion. Good night from us all at Wigmore Hall, and thanks for watching. Here they come back again. And the bravos ring out. The Doric String Quartet taking an elegant bow together. I'm David Owen Norris, and I'll be back next Tuesday and Wednesday with horn trios from Ben Goldschneider, Ben Baker and Tom Poster, and a piano recital from Francesco Piemontesi. Until then.